Please all stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Amen. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary,
and she conceived by the Holy Spirit,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be done to me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And the Word was made flesh,
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. For we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ, your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection. Through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginnings, now and will be forever. Amen.
Mary, help of Christians,
pray for us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Good morning. Together with our personal intentions, we also include the following. For the gift of life and birthday intentions of Michael Lawrence Deason, Zachary Gustilo, Julian, Ethan, Kent Lloyd Mantalaba, Lay Francis, Christopher. Mass offered for the 25th year's marriage of Lute and Wina Baldonado. Thanksgiving Mass for the gift of life offered by Juana Villanueva. For the healing, recovery, and good health of Jeanette Rodrigo, Kiara Kawelan. For the intentions of Ferds Dio, Rosalie Ali and family, Our Lady of Fatima Group of San Diego, Robert and Marilu Paraiso and family. For the eternal repose of the souls of Maria Hazel Maspara Obiso, Benito John Eusebio, Ray Bumapil, Victoria Panis, Rinaldo Suzon, Hinara, Magno, Teresita, Alfonso, Elohio, Charlina, and for the eternal repose of the souls in purgatory. Please all stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
Today we celebrate the memorial of the martyrdom of St. John the Baptist. We pray in this Holy Mass for our personal and community intentions. We also pray for all those who are persecuted because of their faith in the Lord Jesus. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
For we have sinned against you.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy.
And grant us your salvation.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who willed that Saint John the Baptist should go ahead of your Son, both in his birth and in his death, grant that as he died a martyr for truth and justice, we too may fight hard for the confession of what you teach. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The word of the Lord came to me, thus, gird your loins, stand up, and tell them all that I command you. Be not crushed on their account, as though I would leave you crushed before them. For it is I, this day, who have made you a fortified city, a pillar of iron, a wall of brass, against the whole land, against Judah's kings and princes, against its priests and people. They will fight against you, but not prevail over you. For I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You have searched me and you know me, Lord.
You have searched me and you know me, Lord.
O Lord, you have probed me and you know me. You know when I sit and when I stand. You understand my thoughts from afar. My journeys and my rest you scrutinize. With all my ways you are familiar.
You have searched me and you know me, Lord.
Even before a word is on my tongue. Behold, O Lord, you know the whole of it. Behind me and before me, you hem me in and rest your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, too lofty for me to attain.
You have searched me and you know me, Lord.
Please all stand.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
To you, O Lord.
Herod was the one who had John the Baptist arrested and bound in prison on account of Herodias, the wife of his brother Philip, whom he had married. John had said to Herod, "It is not lawful for you to have your brother's wife." Herodias harbored a grudge against him and wanted to kill him, but was unable to do so. Herod feared John, knowing him to be a righteous and holy man, and kept him in custody. When he heard him speak, he was very much perplexed, yet he liked to listen to him. She had an opportunity one day when Herod, on his birthday, gave a banquet for his courtiers, his military officers, and the leading men of Galilee. Herodias' own daughter came in and performed a dance that delighted Herod and his guests. The king said to the girl, "Ask of me whatever you wish, and I will grant it to you." He even swore many things to her. "I will grant you whatever you ask of me, even to half of my kingdom." She went out and said to her mother, "What shall I ask for?" She replied, "The head of John the Baptist." The girl hurried back to the king's presence and made her request. "I want you to give me at once, on a platter, the head of John the Baptist." The king was deeply distressed, but because of his oaths and the guests, he did not wish to break his word to her. So he promptly dispatched an executioner with orders to bring back his head. He went off and beheaded him in the prison. He brought in the head on the platter and gave it to the girl. The girl, in turn, gave it to her mother. When his disciples heard about this, they came and took his body and laid it in the tomb. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today's Gospel presents to us King Herod, who was disturbed by his conscience. Herod was the one who ordered the beheading of John the Baptist. And this prophet, who was the one who stood up for the truth and rebuked him because of his relationship with Herodias, the wife of his brother. All forms of sin, killing, adultery, cheating, stealing, and others disturb the conscience. But if we do not repent of our sins and sinful ways, confess our sins, and ask forgiveness from the Lord, our life will not be at peace. Dili mahapsay ang atong kinabuhi. A spiritual writer said, "There is no pillow so soft as a clear conscience." If our conscience is at peace, we also feel at peace. We walk without any fear, we eat with much gusto, and we sleep peacefully and restfully. As we celebrate today the martyrdom of Saint John the Baptist, we are reminded of our duty as Christians, as followers of our Lord Jesus, to be faithful to God every day and until the end. John the Baptist stood up for what is right and just, for this was how he showed his fidelity to God, who has sent him to proclaim a message of repentance and to prepare the people for the coming of the Messiah. This mission led him to his death, which became a testimony of his faithfulness towards God, who has chosen him, who has loved him, and who has sent him. Siya misaksi sa Dios, pinaagi siyang kinabuhi, ug hangtod pagayod sa iyang kamatayon. Last 2019, the strenna given to the Salesian family was holiness for you, too. We were reminded by the Rector Major, that the successor of St. John Bosco, that God calls everyone to holiness. And becoming a saint is the first and most urgent task for a Christian. St. John Bosco wanted all of us, especially the young, to be happy in time and in eternity. Our father and founder told the young people of his time and all of us today, then we can become saints, we can become holy. He emphasized two sacraments that will be like two wings that can help us fly towards heaven: confession or reconciliation and the Eucharist. Kitang tanan pwede nga makab-ot ang pagkabalaan pinaagi sa pagpuyo ug kinabuhi nga puno sa grasya sa Dios. Brothers and sisters, holiness is for all of us, and it starts by living a cheerful life here on earth with a peaceful conscience. One is truly happy if he or she is at peace with God, with himself or herself, and with others. We ask the intercession of Saint John the Baptist as we strive to be holy until the end. Live with a peaceful and clear conscience and help one another towards that same destination, heaven, with God forever. Many have witnessed to their faith by their lives. Aware of our mission in the world to be prophets, let us pray to our loving Father to make us faithful to our vocation. Let your strength be upon us, Lord. Let your strength be upon us, Lord.
That the Church may fulfill with courage her prophetic mission of proclaiming the gospel without fear or compromise. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let your strength be upon us, Lord.
That government servants may have consciences based upon the bedrock of personal integrity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let your strength be upon us, Lord.
That our community may stand up and speak out for justice and human dignity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let your strength be upon us, Lord.
That the trials of life may not discourage us, but that our faith may grow through them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, strength be upon us, Lord.
That the preaching and example of Saint John may inspire those who live in the shadow of death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Let your strength be upon us, Lord. Almighty God, you bless us with the preaching and example of Saint John. May we offer our lives to your service through our preaching and life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Is a great goal.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
For our good and the good of all His holy church.
Through these offerings which we bring you, O Lord, grant that we may make straight your paths, as taught by that voice crying in the desert, Saint John the Baptist, who powerfully sealed his teaching by the shedding of his blood. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In his precursor, Saint John the Baptist, we praise your great glory, for you consecrated him for a singular honor among those born of women. His birth brought great rejoicing, even in the womb he leapt for joy at the coming of human salvation. He alone of all the prophets pointed out the lamp of redemption, and to make holy the flowing waters, he baptized the very author of baptism and was privileged to bear him supreme witness by the shedding of his blood. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God and Help of Christians, with blessed Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint John the Baptist, and with all the saints in whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, Jose our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, grant to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
spiritual communion. O Jesus, I turn toward the holy tabernacle where you live hidden for love of me. I love you, O my God, I cannot receive you in holy communion. Come nevertheless and visit me with your grace. Come spiritually into my heart, purify it, sanctify it, render it like unto your own. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, as we celebrate the heavenly birth of Saint John the Baptist, that we may revere for what it signifies, the saving sacrament we have received, and even more may rejoice at its clear effects in us. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Let us go and announce the Gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God.